Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to share with you some very important advice related to inverter generators, specifically to Honda EU22i, but you can apply this knowledge to any inverter generator. Most of you probably watched many various videos on YouTube or any other channel about the inverter generators and tests and how they behave, what they can manage and handle, and what you should not do. But only a few of them mentioned what you really must not do, not to destroy them, because it's very easy to destroy them. This one is less than 4 years old and it's dead. It's got less than 22 hours, moto hours, that run, and it's dead. We can say that it's brain dead, because all the signs show, because I have done already some diagnostics, that the inverter unit, inverter module, is damaged. You can't see any cracks, any damage on the capacitors or the rest of the items, but it doesn't work. It creates some kind of resistance, so you cannot pull start properly. It's very hard, and you cannot start the engine. If this 3-pin connector is connected to the inverter unit. So I have decided to record this video to help all of you, and I'll tell you what 7 deadly sins people commit when they're using the inverter generators, and they shouldn't do this. So first one, never shut down the generator with the load on it. Why? The regulator senses the voltage dropping due to the RPM decreasing, and it ramps up significantly to try to compensate. This blows up the capacitors on the regulator, rendering it useless. Always remove the load from the generator prior to stopping the engine. Over here, for example, you've got rectifier. Here you've got inverter unit with many capacitors and the various regulators. So that's the first one. Second, do not let the generator run out of the fuel under the load. Similar things can happen as before mentioned. 3, do not overload the generator. Electricians who are repairing those generators say that the cheaper inverter generators have 2 to 4 lives. It means that you've got resource for 2 to 4 overloads with its automatic shutdown. After this, inverter comes to an end. Starting currents are sometimes 2 times higher, sometimes even 10 times higher than the nominal. For example, some refrigerators needs 10 times higher current, starting current. Keep that in mind, please. Otherwise, you can badly damage the inverter. 4, do not start the generator under the load. It means with the appliances or tools taking power connected. It creates huge pressure on the sensitive electronics, especially when it comes to inverter unit. 5, do not use inverter generator to power the solar system. They were not designed for this purpose. 6, do not use the inverter generator to power welding machines or some types of construction equipment. They are too delicate and not designed for this purpose. And the last one, the last sin that people commit. 7, do not use inverters to power equipment of any kind with brush motors. Why? Because these brush motors, in the event of wear of the brushes, can back toward the generator some power surges that can damage the generator electronic card. To power this kind of tools and equipment, please use classic generators with the classic alternator with stator and heavy motor instead. I would like to remind you that the inverter generator, maybe this one is a little bit better because the Honda is one of the best generators, the small compact generators in the world. These generators, inverters, were not designed for professional use. It is therefore for occasional use. The working section must be not over 3 to 4 continuous hours. Longer would possibly cause alternator to overheat and wear some parts. I hope this short video will help you and will prevent the badly damage of the especially inverter module, which is extremely expensive. While this rectifier, it's kind of a regulator, costs, for example, 65 euro in Europe. This inverter module, it doesn't have any signs of damage. I did contact the Honda dealership, the local one, and they told me that it cost only this item, cost 860 euro plus cost of labor. So with the labor over 920, 950 euro maybe. So please think twice when using these generators and think for yourself whether it's not better sometimes to use classic generators, especially if you've got your own company and employees do use these inverters, because you know yourself that some of them are not very responsible. This can destroy the inverter module and cost you enormous amount of money. Thank you very much for watching. Have a nice day and good luck.